मॉर्निंग, गुड आफ्टरनून, सॉरी। हेलो, इज माय वॉइस इज ऑडिबल? हेलो,
यस सर, यस सर,
यस सर, यू आर ऑडिबल।
ओके, इफ द स्क्रीन इज विजिबल।
यस सर।
ओके, इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड द थर्ड चैप्टर, दैट इज द हाइड्रोलिक सर्किट। बट बिफोर गोइंग टू सर्किट आई हैव टू थिंक दैट everyone must have to know about the different devices which have to be used in a hydraulic circuit for a particular application, and what are the symbols they are used in a hydraulic circuit in order to represent that devices. So today's lecture, in half part, we will continue with the basic fluid power symbols, right? You have to draw these symbols in your notebook. Your time as per the each and every device we will cover and explain and cover. You have to just draw its symbols in your notebook, so you will be better understood what will be the symbol for the particular device that was used in a hydraulic circuit. Are you getting my point? Yes.
Yes, sir.
So, as far as fluid power symbols is to be concerned, in this slide, I am giving the symbols for hydraulic as well as pneumatic, because fluid is the term, common term, which will be applied for hydraulic and pneumatic. As concerned with the hydraulics, we are mainly related with the pumps and motors. Pump and motors are the actuators. Whatever the circle you have drawn, it will be represent pump, motor, or any rotary device. If we are indicating one line and it is having an arrow, there is a triangle. If it is filled, then it will show the direction of flow of hydraulic fluid in a system, fluid power system. If this triangle it is unfilled, then it is related with the pneumatic fluid. If it is filled, it is come under the hydraulic fluid. If it is unfilled, it come under the category of a pneumatic fluid. Line with arrow and arrow, it will indicate the variable displacement. Are you getting this? In hydraulic circuit, in order to represent pump and motor and any other rotary device, you have to use the circle with the extended line which will be diametrically opposite. Then fill the triangle, this one, it will indicate hydraulic fluid, means hydraulic fluid is flowing in a particular direction. If it is a empty one or unfilled one, then it will be indicate pneumatic fluid, that is air. And if we are having a line with the arrow, then it will be, and it will be cross line, it will be not a vertical or not horizontal, it will be something slanting line, then it will indicate the variable displacement. Okay, write in a short in your notebook this notation. Circle, it represents pump, motor, or rotary device. Filled triangle represent hydraulic fluid system. Unfilled triangle, pneumatic fluid system. line with arrow for variable. Is it over? Yes, reply please.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Sir, wait for a while.
Okay. Over.
Yes, sir.
Okay, Prajwal. Then this chart, it will be shows the symbol for pump and motors. Here, this is the description. This will be the symbol. On left side, it will be for hydraulic, and on right side, it's pneumatic. What is the difference? If hydraulic is there, this is a triangle, it is a filled one. And if pneumatic is there, this triangle, it is a unfilled one. So, first symbol, that is the fixed displacement unidirectional pump. If you are considering pump, it will be a circle with the two extended lines, diametrically opposite. This is for the shaft, for the motor, because pump is always have an input from the motor or IC engine, electric motor or IC engine. Now, it is a fixed displacement and unidirectional. Unidirectional for that purpose, it is having a one arrow only, one triangle. In case of pump, this triangle pointer, it must be attached to this circle, right? If you are considering the motor here, fixed displacement unidirectional motor, the base of the triangle, it is attached with the circle in case of a motor base. And in case of pump, this pointer, or we may call corner of this triangle, it will be attached with this circle, connected with the circle, right? It is unidirectional. If it is a fixed displacement, then there will be no necessity of having such kind of arrow, because this arrow, line with the arrow, slanting line with the arrow, inclined line with the arrow, it will indicate the variable displacement. As we are having a fixed displacement, so it consists of only one triangle and this circle. So it will indicate the fixed displacement unidirectional form. For unidirectional, one triangle. As arrow is absent over here, so it will be the fixed displacement pump. Right? If for the pneumatic, this arrow, instead of filled, it will be an unfilled one. Are you getting? If fixed displacement bidirectional pump is there, we are having the two triangles for bidirection. As it is a fixed displacement, there will be no arrow, slanting arrow. Variable displacement unidirectional pump. For unidirectional pump, this is the one filled triangle. As it is a variable displacement, you draw this line, inclined line with the arrow. So it will indicate the variable displacement. One triangle, unidirectional. If two arrows are, two triangles are there, it will indicate bidirectional. Inclined line, it will indicate variable displacement. Absence of inclined line with arrow, it will indicate fixed displacement. Are you getting? Yes? Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
Hello, sir.
Okay.
Hello.
Hmm? Hello.
Sir, what is meant by fixed displacement and variable displacement?
Fixed displacement pump means positive displacement pump, at every rotation or for every movement of the pump, rotating element or sliding element, it will discharge fixed amount of the liquid or fluid at every rotation or for every displacement. So it will become under the category of a fixed displacement form. If variable displacement means for every rotation or for every stroke, we are getting the different output from that pump. So the discharge, it will be a vary. Are you reading?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any doubt? Any more?
No, sir.
So it will be about the fixed displacement, variable displacement, unidirectional and bidirectional pump. Up to this, S4. Right? Now, S5 to S8, it is related with the motor. What change we have made? This triangle, you observe this both triangle. In case of pump, the pointer of the triangle or corner of the pointer, it is attached or connected with the circle. It will indicate the pump. But in case of a motor, the base of the triangle, it is connected or attached with the circle that will represent the pump. Remaining part, it is the same as like a pump. So what it will be? It is a unidirectional one. As there will be no arrow, slanting arrow, so it will be a fixed displacement. Unidirectional fixed displacement motor. This is the fixed displacement unidirectional motor, right? This will be the bidirectional fixed displacement motor. This will be the variable displacement. Inclined arrow is there. This will be the triangle. It is a filler and it is attached with its base to the circle. So it will be a motor. And it is having a single triangle, so it will be a unidirectional variable displacement motor. Bidirectional variable displacement motor. And it will be a oscillating motor. Semicircle is there, base it attached to the diameter, and it will be a oscillating motor. Are you getting this? Difference between pump and difference between the motor, difference between unidirectional, directional, difference between fixed displacement and variable displacement. And accordingly, if these arrows are unfilled ones, they are representing the symbols for the pneumatics. Okay? Are you getting? Just you have to write the description and a hydraulic symbol. In front of each description, you draw the hydraulic symbol and keep some space to draw the pneumatic symbol. So this pneumatic symbol you have to draw at your home. Just you have to draw the hydraulic symbol. Take some time to draw this symbol. Is it over? Hello. Is it over? Can we move forward?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, this slide, it will show the graphical representation of the cylinder. Cylinders are nothing but the actuator, right? Written by external force, right? Cylinder. Single acting means if this will be a cylinder, this will be the piston, and this will be the piston rod. We are providing one port for one side of the piston, inlet port for one side of the piston, and it will be written by external force, means we are supplying the fluid from this port so that this piston, it will be moving in a right hand side, right hand direction. But to move this piston to the left hand side direction, you require certain kind of a external force. So this is a graphical representation of a single acting cylinder. Now, what changed in these two diagrams? Here we are mounting one spring. So the return stroke of this piston, it will be because of this spring action. So this will be the symbol which will representing single acting cylinder, because it is having a one inlet port at a one side of this piston. So it will be a single acting. Now return, here we are providing external force. Here the return of the piston, it will be because of the spring action. This spring is provided for the return movement of the piston in a left hand side. Then there are three cylinders, one, second, and this third one. It is for the telescopic cylinder. It is a symbol for telescopic cylinder, more than one cylinder, right? Concentric cylinder. So it will become under the telescopic cylinder, and it is having a one single inlet port, so it will be called as a single acting telescopic cylinder. Now, in case of a double acting cylinder, we are providing two ports on either side of the piston, on left hand side and on right hand side of the piston. So this symbol, it will representing double acting cylinder with a single piston rod. Here, this will be the cylinder, it will having the two port, two inlet port. So fluid is coming from this side, left hand, this piston, it will be moving towards the right. Then fluid is supplying from the right hand side port, piston is moving towards the left. So this is the symbol for the double acting, because it is having a two ports and it is having a one piston rod. So it will become under category double acting cylinder with a single piston rod. Now, same diagram is there, only one rod, it is attached on left hand side, right? So there are two piston rods are there, two ports, double acting one. So this will be the graphical symbol for double acting cylinder with a two piston rod. This will be the differential cylinder where the diameter of the piston, it will be vary. It will vary the cross section of a internal part of the cylinder. So it will be the symbol for the differential cylinder. Now, double acting telescopic cylinder. Here we are seeing telescopic of the cylinder, telescopic cylinder. But it is having a single port, so it will be a single acting. Here we are providing two ports. For by using the single port, we can extending the cylinder, telescopic cylinder only in one direction. For reverse direction, we have to provide special port for each and every cylinder. So it come under the category of a double acting telescopic cylinder. Then double acting cylinder with a single end position cushioning means, as we have studied in the first chapter, cushioning of the cylinder in order to reduce the jerk when piston is moving in a reverse direction or in a retraction stroke. In order to reduce the jerk, we are providing some cushioning mechanism. If you are observing this piston, this will be a plain piston. And if you are observing this piston, this will be a plain piston with some extension on one side of the piston. So it will representing, it is provided with some provision to provide the cushioning effect, cushioning of the cylinder. So this diagram is a double acting cylinder because we are providing two ports for the two movement of the piston within the cylinder with a single end position cushioning. At one side of the piston, we are providing the provision for the cushioning of the cylinder. In this diagram, what change we have made? We are providing another side of the piston, there will be provision for the cushioning. So this will be the double acting cylinder with the end position cushioning at both the ends, or at both the ends of the piston. And third one, last one, that is a double acting cylinder with the adjustable end position cushioning at both ends. This arrow, it will indicate variable or adjustable cushioning of the cylinder, right? So these are the graphical representations of the cylinder, where we are starting with the single acting by external force, single acting with spring tension return, telescopic with the single acting, double acting with a single piston rod, double acting with a double piston rod on both sides. Here, differential cylinder, double acting. Here, double acting telescopic cylinder, double acting single end cushioning, double acting double end cushioning, double acting variable cushioning both the ends, or adjustable end position cushioning at both the ends. Both the end for these two symbols, two squares, and it will be representing this arrow, it will be representing adjustable end position cushioning. Are you getting this graphical symbol used for cylinders? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay, take some time to draw the symbols. Is all the symbols are clearly visible?
Yes, sir. What? Is it over? Yes, sir.
Single acting with screen, telescope, double acting, double acting, double rod, differential. Double acting telescopic, double acting single end cushioning, double acting double end cushioning, double acting double end adjustable cushioning. Can we move forward?
Yes, sir.
Hello, mute your phone. Okay, we will take the attendance in chat box. A division student, write your roll number. A division student. Anybody is remaining from A division? 62, 2, 65, 25, 34, 49, 62, 42, 63, 1, 44, 17, 8, 55, 9, 45, 33, 58, 16. Saurabh is there? Yes. 24, 28, 60. Seven, zero, two. Okay. Shraddha,
no, you sir, you missed now? My roll number. I texted in chat box also.
Okay. Now B division student, please write your roll number in chat box. Thirty-nine, seventy, twenty-six, twenty-five, seven, 14, 59, 8, 21. Is it anyone remaining from both the division? Please write it. Your roll number. Okay, Pratik is there. Pratik Deshmukh. Pratik.
Hi, yes, sir.
Okay. Sachin, Sachin Wagmare.
Yes, sir.
Sachin is there.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Suraj More. Suraj.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Now we will move forward. Go to slide. Next one. The graphical symbol. Those are used for the direction control wall. This is the 2x2 direction control wall. Means these are the numerator, it will show the ports, and denominator, it will show the position. Positions are shown by the squares. Two squares are there, so it will be a two position wall, and numerator, it will be show the port. There are two ports, right? So this will be the two port, two position wall. Numerator, it will indicate the port 2, 3, 4, right? If two ports are there, 1 and 2. Three ports are there, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Four ports are there, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here we will see A, B, P, T, four port, three port, A, P, T, B is absent here, so three port, two port, A and P, right? So it numerator, it will be shows the number of ports here, A, B, P, T, four port, and number of square, it will show the position. How many squares are there? Two squares. So it will be two position wall. Here, number of position, square, 1, 2, and 3. So denominator, it would be changing to 3. So it will be a three position wall. Rest of all these three, it will show the two position, 2, 2, 2. And this one, it will show the three squares, so it will be three positions. So that this will be the 2x2 direction control wall, 3x2 direction control wall, 4x2 direction control wall, and 4x3 direction control wall. Are you getting this? Symbols of a direction control wall?
Yes, sir.
I think we have drawn these symbols, right?
Yes, sir.
You take some time. If anybody is missing to draw the symbols, take a time and draw the symbols. Okay. Next one, it is a graphical symbol for pressure valve. Set pressure relief valve. Means you have to set the value of the pressure and you are taken the signal for the input from the pump to the tank. This will be the symbol for the pressure relief valve. And adjustable pressure relief valve, what change we have made? We have changed the pressure setting by using the spring, or we may say, we may tell that adjustable spring means by adjusting the tension on spring, we can set the pressure or we can adjust the pressure. So this arrow, it will indicate adjustable pressure relief valve. Without arrow, it will be the set pressure relief valve. And this will be the three-way pressure regulator. Pressure relief valve, in general, we have shown in this way, adjustable pressure relief valve. Three-way pressure regulator means here we can control the flow A to tank, right? Then there will be a certain bypass line. It will be provided to the tank. And also we can adjust the pressure, set the pressure. And also we can sense the pressure at the output. So it will be a three pressure regulator. We mainly concentrate on these two symbols, set pressure relief valve and adjustable pressure relief valve. Okay, can we move forward? Pressure valve symbols are understood. Hello.
Hey, yes, sir.
Oh. Now, flow control valve. Okay. In a flow control valve, this is the symbol. It will be the flow control valve. This line with this semicircle portion, right? And this will be inclined line with the arrow, it will be adjustable. So it will be adjustable flow control valve, and this inclined line, it will be shown orifice or throttle. Means this is the symbol for adjustable flow control valve, adjustable flow control valve with the throttle. Okay, adjustable flow control valve with the orifice. If you have throttle word is there, you draw such kind of line, inclined line, curve line, sorry. And orifice is there, it should be denoted by this plane symbol, formally. And adjustable, for adjustable, this will be the arrow. Now, adjustable with the bypass, in which we are using this adjustable flow control valve, throttle valve, in conjunction with this, you are using this check valve. And check valve is a unidirectional valve. It will allow the flow only in one direction. The reverse direction flow, it will be get blocked. So this will be the, we may say, flow control valve with the check valve. And it is called as adjustable with the bypass. This check valve, it will be used as a bypass valve. Then, we are adding only one, this arrow, straight arrow. It will indicate pressure compensation. So this will be the adjustable bypass valve. Remaining figure is the same if you are removing this arrow. If you are adding this arrow, it will be indicate pressure compensation. If you are added this symbol like a thermometer, so it will be indicate temperature compensated valve. Right? So these are the symbols for the flow control valve. where this is a flow control valve, adjustable flow control valve with the throttle, adjustable flow control valve with the orifice, flow control valve adjustable with the bypass, which is provided by check valve, adjustable with the bypass having a pressure compensation, adjustable with the bypass with the pressure compensation and temperature compensation. There are certain symbols for non-return valve. This is a non-return valve. It will allow the flow only in one direction. The return flow, it will be blocked. And it is provided with the spring. So it will be a spring-loaded non-return valve. If spring is nothing, if spring is not present, it will be unloaded non-return valve. This is the pilot control non-return valve. We are taking the pilot signal at the both sides of the valve. And this will be the shut off valve. This is the symbol for the shut off valve. So these will be representing the non-return valve. These will be representing the symbol for the flow control valve. Take a time to draw the symbols. Symbols of the flow control valve and symbol of the non-return valve. There will be some mistake in this diagram. Setup valve symbol is this one. And this will show the pilot. So pilot control non-return valve. This will be the symbol. Just interchange these two symbols. There will be mistake in book, might be. Are you understood? Pilot control and setup valve symbols. Interchange that symbols. Are you getting or not? Hello?
Yes, sir.
You have to interchange 34 and 35. Symbol number 34 and 35. Setup valve symbol is this. And pilot control non-return valve symbol is this. Over. Hurry up. We have to complete at least symbol in this lecture. Interchange these symbols. This will be the symbol for the shut-off valve. Setup valve, it will be active wash basin wall, or we will use the wall at a wash basin where we are rotating the knob and controlling the flow, right? This will be the pilot control non-return wall. You are taking the sim pressure sensation signal from the pressure. It may be from input or output. Accordingly, this wall, it will be operate. It will be allow the flow or block the flow. So this dotted line indicated by X, it will show the pilot signal. Right? It will be taken from inlet of any device or outlet of the any device. Accordingly, it will operate. Anybody can tell in which direction the flow will be flow in this diagram, and in which direction flow it will be blocked? Yes. In which direction the flow it will be flow, and in which direction flow
B.
it will be blocked? Vertical direction, what is flow? It will be flow, right? Fluid, it will be flow, right? And in which direction it will be blocked?
B to A.
B to A. Right. Okay. Can we move forward?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Is it over? Okay. There are certain methods for actuation of the direction control wall. Right? So these are the graphical symbols used for method of operation, for operating of the wall, for operating. There are certain methods we are using, and they are representing by symbol. So pressure compensator is there, then you have to use the arrow in this hand. Detent setting, certain setting you have to put this arrow partially within this rod and partially outside this rod. If you have to operate this wall manually, it will be shown by this symbol. Mechanically, shown by this roller shape symbol. Circular. Pedal, this symbol. Push button, this symbol. This is the push button. This will be for the pedal. This will be for mechanical. It may be a roller. This will be the manual actuation. This will be detent setting and pressure compensation. Next one. When you are actuating the wall by using the lever, it will be shown by the symbol. It will be as like a pedal, but instead of the slanting line, you have to use the circle. So it will be considered as a lever operated. Pilot pressure. This is the triangle, fill triangle. Solenoid. It will be inclined line. This will be a solenoid with the pilot, right? Solenoid control, pilot pressure operated. This will be the spring operated. And this will be the servo, servo motor operated, right? This symbol, it will be indicated for the servo. Here, pressure compensated, dented setting, manual, mechanical, pedal, push button, lever, pilot, solenoid, solenoid with the pilot, spring and servo operator. Right? These are the certain actuation methods of the wall. Are you getting this actuation method? In a hydraulic circuit, when you are observing direction control wall, at both end of the direction control wall, there will you are observing such kinds of the symbols. So there will be a specific meaning of for that symbol. It will be spring operated, right? It will be roller operated or mechanical operated, push button type, spring operated, solenoid one. Are you getting this actuation symbol or method of operation?
Yes,
Hello?
Sir.
Okay. Is it required to draw or can we move forward?
Sir, wait for a few minutes.
Okay. Filled triangle, which one? Filled one, pilot operated.
Yes, sir.
Can we go to next slide? Okay. These are the symbols which are related to the energy transmission. Hydraulic pressure source. It will be lined with a filled arrow. Electric motor. Non-electric drive unit. These are the line, it will indicate pressure line, power line, return line. Dotted line, it will be shown. Dotted with the long chain, long dash. So it will be a pilot line. Small dash, it will be dotted with small dash, drain line. The exhibit line. Line connection. Line crossing. Exhaust, weak acting coupling with a non-return valve. This will be the reservoir. This will be the pressurized reservoir. Here, this will be the filter. This will be the cooler. And this will be the heater. Cooler and heater. Heater, in case of a heater, arrow is connecting to each other. In case of a cooler, arrow in a outward direction. This will be the filter. In certain cases, filter, it will be horizontally mounted. In certain cases, usually, this will be vertically mounted. These three diagrams, they are shown. This diagram, it will be shown horizontally mounted. Actually, it will be vertically mounted. Vertical filter. print currently. So there will be no need to draw all the symbols. Just keep in mind reservoir, filter, cooler, heater, certain line connections, crossing. If in some tilting line is there, flexible line, pilot, motor, and hydraulic pressure. Then we have seen the accumulator intensifier, right? In which this will be the symbol for the accumulator. This will be the spring-loaded accumulator. This triangle unfilled, so it will be gas charge. This will be the rectangle triangle. It will be indicate weighted accumulator. Weighted accumulator, gas charge, spring-loaded, and plane accumulator. These are the symbols for the accumulator. Pressure gauge, thermometer, flow meter, and level indicator, fluid level indicator. These are the simple. These are the couple without check valve. This we are allowing to flow in both directions. This will be coupled with the check valve. This will be symbol for the check valve. Both direction it will be coupled in a both flows. It will be coupled in a one central direction without check valve, and this will be with check valve. This will be the half of quick release coupling without valve. This will be the half of keep release coupling with the check valve. If this circle is shown over here, then it will be a check valve. Without circle, without check valve. Right? So you might be known these symbols. You draw the symbols related to the accumulator and you remind these symbols, pressure, thermometer, flow meter, level indicator. Just you have to draw this symbol. Accumulator, okay, we will move to the next slide. End of this slide. Is it over? Symbols of the accumulators are over. We will stop over here. In next lecture, we will start with our third chapter. That was we are already started, but I think that majority of the students are not knowing the symbols. For that purpose, we are taking a recap or overview of this symbol. In next lecture, we will continue with the third chapter. Thank you. Thank you very much.